Hello and welcome students to the next video. And in this video I'm going to show you in the applications that how you can create your own personal dictionary using crunch command, right? So inside password attacks you can see there's a command, there's a tool, basically it's a tool, crunch tool, right? And the work of this tool is to create your own personal dictionary, right? So let me show you how you can do that. So if you select password attacks, right, you can click on crunch, and inside crunch there are some options available. Let me show you what are the options available there. So the command for crunch is this: crunch, min, max, and options available. So for example, let me show you one thing. Let me clear everything right now. It's fine. So for example, like my name is Sunil, S-U-N-I-L, and I want to create all the permutation combinations of my name. So how we can do that? We can do this by using crunch command. So let me show you how you can do that. So you can simply type crunch space the minimum characters. For example, the minimum character is 1, the maximum character is 5, the pattern means the string. So for example, this is the string, and the way you want to save the file: /root/desktop/sunil.txt. So what I'm doing here, I'm creating all the permutation combinations of my name. My name is S-U-N-I-L, right? So you can start with the first name. First, for example, it will take one of them. Then it will take 2 of them, then 3, 4, and then it will end at 5 characters, right? So this is the crunch command. Where you want to save the file: -o for output. Where you want to save the file, you can save this file on desktop with the name of sunil.txt, right? So let me show you. Hit enter, and it is creating 3905, and the command has been completed. It has been executed. Let me minimize that. You can see here on the screen that there is a file which has been created by crunch command. And if I open this file, then you can see on the screen, let me show you one thing. Yeah, here you can see that it has started with a single character. It has taken a single character. Then it has taken 2 characters. Then after that, it is taking 3 characters, right? And then after that, it is taking 4 characters. And then later, it is taking 5 characters. So it is taking, actually this is a dictionary of my name. It is containing all kind of permutation combinations of my name, you can see on the screen, right? So these dictionaries can help you, for example, if you want to try on some kind of password attacks, right, or protocol attacks, etc. So these dictionaries can help you in that. So that's why crunch command is really necessary you to understand. All right, let me close everything. Now let me open the terminal again. This was the command. What if I change it to 3, 5? What will happen if I do this? If you change it to 3, 5, then it will skip the single character. It will skip the 2 characters. It will start with the 3 characters. Then it will take 4 characters. Then it will take 5 characters. It means it will skip 1 and 2 characters. Let me show you how. You can hit enter. It is creating 3875. It was 3905 initially. Minimize it and open that file again. So if I come up, you can see here that it has skipped a single character and 2 characters from your dictionary. It is taking 3 characters, and then if you come down, then it is taking 4 characters, and then if you come down, it is taking 5 characters. So there is no place for single and double characters here, right? And you can, if you want, you can skip the 3rd characters. If you want all kind of 5 characters only, that you want to skip single, double, triple, and 4 characters, so you can hit enter. So there will be only 5 characters inside that. Let me open this file again. So you can see here that it only contains only 5 characters. It is starting with the 5. There is no place for single, double, triple, or 4 characters. Right, so that's how you can use crunch command to create kind of dictionary. So crunch is the command, 5 is the minimum character, 5 is the maximum character, Sunil is the pattern, Dash O is means for output, where you want to save the file. I want to save this file on my desktop with the name of sunil.txt. So you can see here, this is the name of the file, sunil.txt, and it has been saved on the desktop with the name of sunil.txt. Great. Now let me show you one more thing. Let me clear everything. Yeah. Now, for example, if you want to insert some kind of special characters inside it, so how you can do that? Let me show you with my name. So for example, the password is sunil@$ is the password. And if you want to create a dictionary of this, so is it possible or not? Let's try. So let me type crunch space 57 sunil@$ space dash smallo, where you want to save the file, /root/desktop/ sunil1.txt. All right, so what I'm doing here, I'm taking seven characters here, and inside that one of, basically two of them are special characters, @$. So I'm starting with five characters, and it will go with six, and then end with seven characters. So if you want to run this, let's run this file. It is, you can see there that it is making a lot of lines here, right? So if I open this file, so you can see here that all these files are available here. All this information is available here, and you can see here that all the special characters have been merged inside these lines. So you don't need to worry about special characters. You can also create a dictionary with special characters as well, right? So that's how you can create the dictionary with special characters. And if you want to create a dictionary with numbers, you can also do that. Let me click on the upper arrow and let me change it to 12 and hit enter. Same number of lines, 9,57,999. Minimize that. Open the sunil1.txt file, and you can see here that you can also merge the numeric values with the characters, right? Let me close, let me open this. If you want, you can also merge special characters with numeric values. For example, if I change it to 1, or for example, sunil2@$. So this is the file, hit enter. Minimize it, open sunil1.txt, and here you can see that numeric values and special characters have been inserted inside that. Right, you can see here. So you can create any kind of dictionary. You can create basically a dictionary, a personal dictionary. You can create a dictionary with alphanumeric values. You can create a dictionary with simple characters. Any kind of character you can insert in the dictionary by using crunch command, right? So that's why crunch command is really necessary you to understand, because if you want to create your own dictionary, then this crunch tool can help you to do that. Right, so this is all about the crunch command. I hope you liked it, and we will come back in the next video with more interesting videos. Thank you.